Alabama head coach, who was with us live from SEC Media Days. Coach, thank you very much for taking the time to do this. And I want to start with this because I promised myself I would. I understand that you scheduled your hip replacement for the afternoon so you could play golf that morning. Can you take me through the thinking on that day?
Yeah, well, they told me I wasn't going to be able to play for 8 weeks, so I wanted to get that last round in. But I actually played in 3.5 weeks, so you know, it worked out great. But we played in the morning in Florida. We got in the plane, went to the hospital, got surgery in the afternoon, left the next morning, and went to work the next day. So they did a great job. But, you know, there's one thing I like to mention, just because you guys were talking about expectations for the Nets and the Celtics and all that. You didn't create any for us just now in your introduction, and I really appreciate that.
I didn't. I just ran through the litany of all the things that you've accomplished. I trust that was sarcasm. I know sometimes it's difficult to tell. Well, let's talk about the success, because one of the burdens of success is that you lose a lot of coaches, which obviously you have over the course of the last few years. How has that impacted the program, both on the field and in recruiting?
Well, I think it's always great when you have continuity, but I also think when you have some turnover, especially when it's positive for the people who've done a great job for you, which a lot of our assistants have done a fabulous job for us, and that's why they do it. They have goals and aspirations and things that they want to accomplish, and, you know, I'm happy for them to be able to reach some of those goals, and it does create an opportunity for us to bring new energy and enthusiasm and ideas to our organization, even though continuity for players is really, really important, because I think relationships with coaches and players is really important to being successful. But the one thing we've been able to do is the coaches that we brought in have done a really good job of creating those relationships with the players that we have on our team right now.
And so one of those will be, Steve Sarkisian this year, your new offensive coordinator, working with your young star quarterback, Tua Tagovailoa. In what areas would you expect Tua to be better this year than he was a year ago?
Well, I think Tua played outstanding football for us all year last year, but probably not quite as good in the end as in the beginning. You know, he didn't have any interceptions for the first 7 or 8 games, and then he had 6 or 7 at the end of the season. So I really think that patience, decision-making, taking what the defense gives. I think sometimes when you have success, you want to have more success. So maybe you start forcing plays, trying to make plays down the field, trying to make explosive plays when maybe they're not there. And I think that might have happened a little bit to us, you know, a year ago, because we were so explosive on offense due to Tua. But now that should be a learning experience for him to, you know, stay disciplined and focused on the reads that you have and taking what the defense gives on a consistent basis. And I think we can eliminate some of those turnovers.
Now, let me go back to your point about expectations for a moment, because here on this show already today, we've already talked about Bama, Georgia, and we've already talked about Bama, Clemson. Obviously, you have a lot of work to do before we get anywhere near either of those. So how do you approach those expectations with your players?
Well, I think that the number one thing that we try to do is establish an internal standard and not worry about external expectations. And, you know, we want to get our team to play to the highest level. And we've always tried to establish discipline as being a big part of what we want to do, be a very disciplined team, have a team full of guys that, you know, can be accountable and responsible to each other and to do their job, and for everybody to put the team first. And I think that if we can get that, we obviously have some talented players, but to get them to play to that standard on a consistent basis is going to determine how much success we have throughout the season.
I've always been fascinated in recent years about how that has changed in recent years because of all the increase in attention in media, in social media. How different is your ability to control that with your players from what it was, let's say, 10 or 15 years ago?
Well, I think it is much more difficult now because there's so much information out there. You mentioned, you know, whether it's social media, Twitter, however it comes. And I think the attention is good for college football. I think the attention is good for sports, you know, in general. But I also think it's more difficult for the individual to stay focused on the things that are in front of him and not to be affected by the external factors and expectations that other people may create for them. Because being able to stay focused on the process of what you need to do to accomplish the goals that you have is probably even more important than the outcome itself. So that's what we try to do. It is a little more difficult in this day and age, but those are the kind of challenges I think that if you can successfully manage, it creates an advantage for you.
Because one more thing before I let you go, and I so appreciate this as always. With all the success that you've had and your legendary hard work ethic, when do you get a chance in your life to reflect on what you've accomplished and what it means to you?
Well, I really don't do that. I mean, you know, I think if you're in this profession, knowing that, you know, success is not a continuum, it's momentary. And if you're going to continue to be successful, you got to stay focused on the next thing. You know, the road to success is always under construction. So I'm still motivated by the next season, the next game, the next play, motivating the next player. So I really don't look back much. You know, one of these days, maybe when I'm not doing this anymore, I'll be able to reflect on some of the things that were good and bad. But it's my goal that, you know, players say that they were affected in a positive way and were able to be more successful in their life because they were involved in our program. And I think that would be the legacy that I would want to have established about my career more than anything else.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports and analysis, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus.